data from the tumor. Dr. Zeneta, MD and PhD, obstetric and gynecology, specialist in athletic gynecology. Her talk about the local estrogen treatment for vulvovaginal atrophy in postmenopausal women. Dr. Zeneta.
Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, I would like to say thank you very much for all organizing committed to invite me as a speaker to this very interesting conference in such beautiful and historic city, Cairo. It is my honor, and I am very glad that today I have possibility to share with you my experience. I will present today my study about comparison of hyaluronic acid injection and local estrogenic treatment for vulvovaginal atrophy in postmenopausal women. But first of all, let me introduce you a little bit about global statistic analysis and show how it's important to diagnose and to treat this condition. According to world statistic analysis, about 50-60% women in menopause are suffering from this condition in silence, and only 25-30% receive adequate treatment. Many patients are embarrassed to discuss intimate complaints with the specialist and take it like a natural aging process. So also, it's a very important fact that our days quality of life is getting better, and average life expectancy is getting longer. Even more women reach menopause. Even more women reach menopause, we as a doctor, we have to find different, very effective methods to treat our patient in this period. The aim of my study was to elevate which one hyaluronic injection or estrogen vaginal suppositories are better for the women in menopause who never performed hormone replacement therapy. My following task is first to analyze which one symptoms were mostly common for the women with vulvovaginal atrophy, and second, how to give in treatment reduce the symptoms. But it is the questions. Why I compare these two methods? And I will answer you. All gynecologists agree with me that the best method to treat vulvovaginal atrophy is local estrogen therapy or, in general, hormone replacement therapy. But we know also that our patients have a different opinion about hormone replacement therapy. And here I want to show you different generations and different opinions about hormone treatment. First, young generation is more open and trusted in hormone treatment because of a lot of young girls assumes contraceptive pills so they are more likely not to be afraid of hormonal treatment. And other generation, these days generations, elder women have a lot of fears of hormone replacement therapy because of weight gain, cancer fear, hirsutism fear, or they have contraindications, estrogen-dependent malignant tumor, vaginal bleeding, history of arterial or venous thromboembolism, and acute liver disease. I want to remind a little bit what is atrophic vulvovaginitis. The first of all, deficiency of estrogen in menopausal women leads to the development of atrophic process in urogenital tract. The second, proliferation of vaginal epithelium seizes, the mucous membrane became thins out, resulting in dryness and slight vulnerability. The first signs of atrophic vaginitis occur approximately 5 years after the onset of the last menopausal period. In my study, I included 65 menopause women. They are divided into groups. First groups, women were treated with hyaluronic acid injections, 45 women, and second group were treated with locally estrogenic vaginal suppositories. Before the treatment, all patients had full gynecological examinations, included colposcopy, pH measurement of vaginal discharge, macrobiological studies, cytological examination, I mean cervical pap smear. Sexual transmitted disease, of course, were excluded. Before start the treatment, all my patients had dryness. 37 patients had dyspareunia, 24 burning sensations, and 6 patients had pathological watery discharge from vagina. First group of women were treated with multipoint intramucosal injection of cross-linked hyaluronic acid in the vagina vestibule, and treatment was performed every 6 months. Second group with estradiolum 0.5 milligram suppositories were applied 2 weeks, one per day, and later two per week for 2 months. Treatment was repeated in 4 months. What is the differences between hyaluronic acid injection and estrogen treatment? The injection of hyaluronic acid restores volume, hydration, and smoothing of tissue. The action of hyaluronic is stimulation of intracellular hydration and formation and new collagen fibers, maintaining the main characteristic of young and healthy tissue, firmness, elasticity, and more. Hyaluronic acid-based treatment may be recommended for women who are reluctant to use estrogen and for whom who use estrogen is contraindicated. Women usually prefer hyaluronic injection treatment because it's a long pause between treatment. Treatment we can repeat every 6 months. Local estrogen treatment is effective and simple to use, but many women want to avoid estrogen as advised not to use it for the cancer diagnosis. Women usually do not prefer local estrogen treatment because of the taking routine. They are used the field discharge every day. And my study results showed that both hyaluronic acid and estrogen vaginal suppositories can improve clinical symptoms of vaginal dryness in postmenopausal women. The results of this study showed that symptoms of vaginal atrophy compared with the baseline level were revealed significantly in both groups. Dryness, itching were revealed significantly in both groups, but dyspareunia only showed improvement in hyaluronic acid groups. In conclusion, I can to say that both hyaluronic acid injection and estrogen vaginal suppositories are very effective in treatment for vaginal dryness. Hyaluronic acid injection may be considered as a valid alternative to estrogen-based treatment in relieving the symptoms of vaginal dryness and more effective for dyspareunia treatment. Hyaluronic acid injection is alternative treatment who cannot use hormone replacement therapy and is very comfortable treatment because can be performed every 6 months. The clinical effect consists of improving trophism of the mucous membranes, reducing the pathological phenomenon of angiogenesis, dryness, bacterial vaginitis, and restoring the normal pH of vagina. It is possible to recommend long course of the therapy as well as preventive prescription of the medication. I really strongly advise this method for the women like alternative treatment for local estrogenic therapy because it's very simple to perform, doesn't take a lot of time and fully painless. It just takes 10, 15 minutes with the local anesthesia.
Now the next talk.